moral priorities of the designers and engineers who are making this. And I think that that's also where we need to place our scrutiny, that when we talk about the legal infrastructures in place to handle cyber violence, how is this technology being built in the first place? Who are the people who are building this technology? Are we putting engineers into a black box and making them escape the scrutiny? So, you know, also to talk about those kinds of choices that the designers of technology make that sometimes enable the abuse or do not reach up to their potential in engaging with it.